bistability, which is to show two different stable states. For instance, those slab bracelets that are stretched or curled. It's the geometry and the way you arrange it that dictates the behavior. So for example, with domes, it starts concave shape, and then we apply some pressure, and then this dome inverts and becomes convex. That shows the two positions that this unit cell can adopt. When you start patterning sheets with these domes, when you invert two that are close to one another, they somehow start interacting. And this interaction creates a globally curved surface. Depending on which domes are inverted, you get different shapes. So one of the functionalities of these metamaterials that we devise is this grasping. When you grasp onto something, you are actually spending energy when you maintain a grip. What is very interesting about this gripper is that we use the local stability of the units to change the shape, so essentially to go from an open state to a closed state. When we invert the domes that make the gripper close, we are storing energy into the gripper. And that energy is the energy that is pushing against whatever it is grasping and keeping the grip. You can think of it as we're using the structure as a battery, as a mechanical battery. That is precisely what we're doing. Depending on their height, we would be able to program the pressure at which they snap to the other state. So this is a way in which you could potentially actuate and invert the dome selectively by using a pressure threshold. Even more important is the order of inversion. Depending on the initial condition and the history, your final property is going to be different. This is the trademark of hierarchical multistable behavior, not found in other types of metamaterials. It's quite a unique property. We believe that there is a big role that these structures can play in flexible robotics. So if we could make a hand and you could just by pressure change the grasps, then you would greatly simplify the control problem and have an anthropomorphic manipulator with 90% of the dexterity. You don't really understand how interesting it is until you start playing with it physically. Whole is greater than the sum of the parts.